Hi, I'm filmmaker Sunil Darshan and we are talking on the pre-release of my movie Ek Haseena Thi, Ek Deewana Tha.
Thank you so much for spending your time with us, Sunil.
My pleasure.
We are here with Chain to Bollywood and we have a few questions to ask him.
Sure.
Thank you so much and congratulations on your upcoming film.
Thank you for that.
What do you look for in a young actor when you plan to launch them?
Well, it depends on what the requirement of the moment is. So when I was casting for Andaz, I needed a mature looking girl to play the role Lara Dutta did. I needed a bubbly, vivacious girl for the role which Priyanka Chopra did. Coming back to Ek Haseena Thi, Ek Deewana Tha, the girl Natasha in the movie had needed to have too many shades to herself because the movie centered around her. With the two boys, played by Shiv Darshan, my son, and Upen Patel. So I went about looking for fresh faces, and I ran into this girl at a restaurant where she was sitting and having a dinner salad, and she was talking to the waiter, and I actually saw her perform 100 different expressions. I was quite motivated by that moment, and I called her to my table, and not only was she a pretty girl, but she had a good height, a good structure, everything that I felt would be needed in the character that I was trying to create in Natasha. And that's how Natasha Fernandez was born.
So is this usually how you find actors that you want to launch? Or is there usually a more conventional way of
interviewing? I really don't understand what conventional means. I just understand that when I'm working, I work 24 hours on my film. So if I find something that's unusual or something that would benefit my movie, I would love to cast that person there and approach that person there. I have no shame in doing that.
Okay. During your career, since 1999, have you ever encountered any mistakes or...
Whose career?
Your career.
I've been working, I started my movies in 1987. When I started the production of a film called Intakam with Sunny Deol and Anil Kapoor in lead roles.
Okay.
After that, I made my next movie which started in 1990 and we released it at the beginning of 1993. That was called Lutere. That had Sunny Deol, Nasiruddin Shah, Chunky Pandey, Juhi Chawla, Pooja Bedi and Anupam Kher. Thereafter, I made Ajay which had Sunny Deol and Karishma Kapoor, released at the fag end of 1996. In 1999, I released my movie Janwar, which was a blockbuster hit, which featured Karishma Kapoor, Akshay Kumar and Shilpa Shetty. Thereafter, in 2001, I released Ek Rishta, in which I got the opportunity of working with the wonderful Amitabh Bachchan, along with Akshay Kumar, Rocky, Karishma Kapoor, Juhi Chawla, Sunil Shetty and a lot of other actors. In 2003, I produced, in 2002 before that, I would say, I produced Haan Maine Bhi Pyar Kiya, which had some fantastic scores by Nadeem Sharma and featured Akshay Kumar, Karishma Kapoor and Abhishek Bachchan in lead roles. In 2003, January, I released Talash, The Hunt Begins, which starred Akshay Kumar and Kareena Kapoor together. 2003, May, I released Andaz, which had Akshay with Lara Dutta and Priyanka Chopra. 2005 thereafter, I released Barsaat, which had Bobby Deol, Priyanka Chopra and Bipasha, with some fabulous songs by Nadeem Sharma. 2005 end, there was Dosti with Akshay Kumar, Bobby Deol, Kareena Kapoor, Lara Dutta and Juhi Chawla. 2006, there was Mere Jeevan Saathi with Akshay Kumar, Karishma Kapoor and Amisha Patel. Most of my movies had music by Nadeem Sharma at that point. Then I did a switch and I made of genre, of the kind of cinema I did. I thought I'd experiment with changing times. And I made a movie called Shaka Laka Boom Boom. It had Bobby Deol, Kangna, Upen Patel and Selena Jaitley in principal roles. A music by Himesh Rishamya. Thereafter I took a gap. I had worked for 2 decades, made over a dozen movies, most of them successful, and I thought I'd take a little gap, but the gap just got stretched and now I come back to cinema as a filmmaker where I'm producing and directing and writing my film called Ek Haseena Thi Ek Deewana Tha. It has music by Nadeem. Rather, I'd say it has some fantastic music by Nadeem. And it stars my son Shiv Darshan, a new girl, Natasha Fernandez, and Upen Patel in leading roles.
What drives you towards making a new film? Is there some emotional connect that you have with every film? Is there a story, a backstory behind every film?
Well, I have always worked because I enjoyed working. I was fortunate enough that I could afford to survive without working when I didn't feel like. But every moment I wanted to do cinema, and whenever I make cinema, for me cinema is not a mind calculation. Unlike today when cinema has become content, I still maintain stubbornly that I make cinema. And there's a drastic difference between cinema and content. But I stand to choose to make cinema even today.
Do you see success in launching great actors like Akshay Kumar in where they are right now?
I feel proud, I feel happy to see successful actors. I mean, I actually feel that, you know, they have been very kind to me to let me launch them, because actors come with a sizable ego, you know. So they wouldn't like thought of being launched by someone. They wouldn't like to look back and feel. They need to be told that, you know, the world belongs to them. So having said that, whether it's Akshay Kumar or any other actor, you see, I feel very obliged, and I feel very happy that they have given me the opportunity to launch them.
You've mentioned great names of actors in the films that you've worked on. Has it ever been a situation where things have not just worked out between you and an actor, or something didn't gel out, or some miscommunication or something happened?
Well, I was working with an actor called Sunny Deol, with whom I made my first three movies through a decade. Thereafter, I was supposed to make my fourth film with him. It didn't happen. A very unfortunate incident which left me terribly hurt and wounded, you know. And he was one star who I put on a pedestal. And I seriously thought, you know, that everyone needs a leader. So I thought maybe, you know, he somewhere belongs to a new genre, a new generation, and a new kind of cinema. But somehow we had to call it a day, and I thought it was fortunate for me at one point when I realized that without him I made more successful cinema than I made with him.
Do you think the industry should run with mentors like yourself?
I don't consider myself a mentor of sorts. I'm just a worker, I'm just a filmmaker. On my movies, I'm the producer, director, writer. Right down to the spot boy's job, I don't feel ashamed in doing that, for the simple reason that I believe that's a part of the filmmaking process. And I could do anything for filmmaking.
So why, what is the special connect you have with filmmaking? Has there ever been an experience where you said, oh, I'm so happy with this job that I have right now?
I always dreamt as a child. I came from a film family, and films for me, for my family, you know, according to my family, were a big no-no. They wanted me to study and grow beyond. But then, you know, when things are not really easily available, then your desire or quest to achieve that becomes much more. And that's how my entire journey into films, it was very tedious. But it was determination and drive, sincerity and honesty, and that one focus, you know, to be in cinema that actually brought me here.
Throughout your entire journey, what have been some of the inspirations and philosophies that kept you going?
Well, there's a Johnny Walker saying, keep walking. And there was this wonderful song in Subhash Gaiji's Meri Jaan, which said, Zindagi Har Kadam Ek Nayi Jaan. So I said, okay, fine. Take every movie as a battle, enjoy it, try to succeed so that you can get into the next.
To all the young producers out there, what message would you like to give them when they are starting their career in this time and age?
I just feel that all the filmmakers of present time should try to make films. We are unfortunately tied by a strange word called content, you know, and content is for television, but film is for cinemas. And when you make films, it's not about what you feel satisfied by. You have to see the audience and what the audience taste is, and you have to cater to that multitude. We often have a lot of, you know, we live in Bombay city, and in this island city, we haven't really seen much of what India is about, you know. So I feel filmmakers who really want to make cinema that goes to the highest number of people worldwide should actually travel a lot, see the taste, see the preferences, the likes and the dislikes of filmmakers, rather than sitting and reading trade magazines over here, you know, and collecting assumed and perceptional stories which have been plugged into magazines. Should go and actually interact with people, and you'll come out with beautiful cinema.
Thank you so much, sir, for spending your time with us and educating us about your life and experiences.
It's really been my pleasure to talk to you, and I would love want your audience to come and watch Ek Haseena Thi Ek Deewana Tha at cinemas on 30th June.